Fox, Genco Shipping and Trading, as well as Baltic Trading, reporting their respective quarterly results less than an hour ago, topping analyst estimates. Well, here to talk about the numbers and the industry, we have John Wobensmith. He is the Chief Financial Officer of Genco. He's also the President and Chief Financial Officer of Baltic Trading. John, good to have you with us on Bloomberg.
Yeah, thank you, Pimm.
All right, so what are the results? Give us, you know, this is like the Oscars. All right, so the winner is Genco Trading. How are the results in the dry bulk sector doing?
They've been okay. I mean, Genco obviously put up a good number, as well as Baltic. And I think what's exciting for really both companies, one, Baltic is has declared its first quarterly dividend since going public, which is 16 cents a share. And Genco has been acquiring ships, and we've done two large acquisitions over the last couple months.
What about the acquisitions? I mean, why buy ships right now if you see, let's just call it, a muted market for dry bulk charter rates?
Well, actually, what we've seen is there are very few companies that have capital available to them to acquire ships. And because of that, vessel values have come down pretty significantly. We've basically hit the reset button back to 2004 levels. And particularly with the ships that we've been acquiring, the Supermax tonnage, those rates have actually held up very well over the summer. And we're still getting 15, 16% unlevered cash-on-cash returns.
So what are you going to be hauling in these Supermaxes? I mean, are we going to talk about grain, for example, or is it more iron ore and coal?
Well, that's the nice thing about the Supermax tonnage. They actually carry iron ore, coal, grain, as well as all the minor bulks. What's happening right now is we've had a seasonal slowdown in the summer because we're in between the South American grain season coming into the U.S. grain season, which looks to be actually pretty strong.
All right, so if you're going to have a grain season that's strong, do we then wait to see what happens in China in terms of their demand for iron ore and coal? Are they playing a waiting game?
They're playing a waiting game on the iron ore side. We've just started to see increased fixtures, particularly in the Capesize sector, over the last week. But what the Chinese have been doing for the last 30, 45 days is playing, as you said, a waiting game and drawing down their inventories. And now they're slowly starting to come back into the market, and you've seen Capesize rates start to recover.
Now, as I mentioned, you know, you're the Chief Financial Officer of Genco, but you're also the President and Chief Financial Officer of Baltic Trading. What's the difference between the two companies? They're both dry bulk operators, but Baltic Trading, which recently came public, is really focused on the spot market, right?
That's correct. Baltic is focused on the spot market. We became public in March of this year. We now have six vessels on the water, and really, the idea behind Baltic is to be a spot player, low leverage, and a high dividend payout. So as I said, this is the first quarter that we declared our dividend. It was actually a stub quarter because we didn't have all the ships on the water yet for this quarter.
All right, and so when you say spot market, that means sort of the daily market for ship charters, nothing that is going to be chartered for a long period of time.
That's correct. It fluctuates daily. We have a concentration right now in Supermax vessels, which has obviously been very beneficial, particularly, you know, this summer.
What do you get for a Supermax? I mean, if I was going to call you and say, I need a Supermax vessel to haul some grain from, you know, Brazil or, you know, Argentina all the way to China, what would I be having to pay?
About $18,000 a day is what the current spot rate is. And if you back that into Baltic's free cash flow break-even number, which is only about $9,000 a day, you can see how there's significant cash flow is generated.
Are the journeys, are the actual number of days that the ships spend between the loading ports and the unloading ports, is that changing in the marketplace?
We've definitely seen port congestion, if that's what you're referring to, meaning there's a lot of cargo that's moving, there's a lot on the demand side, and because of that, ships do line up waiting for ports, and obviously that's good for us because ships are out of the market for a longer period of time.
And are the actual distances increasing between, let's say, the exporters of grain and the importers?
Definitely on the grain side. In fact, what is believed right now, because the Russians have put a ban on the export of wheat, that slack is going to have to be taken up from Australia and the United States, which means a longer haul demand and ton-mile expansion.
All right. I want to thank you very much, John Wobensmith, coming in Chief Financial Officer of Genco, also the President and Chief Financial Officer of Baltic Trading. Thanks for the insight into the world of shipping.
Great.